Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Dark Game Channel. I'm AJ Gels. Guys, we're back with Mass Effect Andromeda. I'm gonna stick with the priority ops right now. I want to get into the ship, get into some free roam, you know, out into the galaxy and, you know, exploring and whatnot. We'll come back. We will definitely be doing, like, this Ryder family secrets, finding the other arcs. You know, we'll get to know the Nexus. You know, we'll do all of those. Okay, somehow I've lost connection. I don't know. It's weird. Either way, we're gonna go, go get our ship. I think it's, from what I remember, it's called the Tempest? I do want to see, can we go see Sarah anywhere? Is there, I can't, is there like a map of this place? Oh, wait. How about that middle thing that says map? Oh, okay, that's neat. You pick where you want to go through the by looking at it. It's not like you have to go to one specific location. It's kind of hard to pick where you want to go, though.
I'll make it right. Legs feeling a little better.
Looks like the muscles are
moving. Greer, how are you feeling?
I'm sure the bastard's
grateful. If you and Liam hadn't found me in that cave, God knows what those aliens would have done.
We couldn't leave a man behind.
Yeah, your father, and Kirkland.
We'll never forget their sacrifice. It's a brave thing, risking your life for the greater good.
Yeah, just seems unfair. We barely got here. I'm sorry I'm not out there with you, but Kirkland was a friend, and I'm not cut out for this anymore.
Understood. Habitat 7 was a nasty wake-up call. You take care, Greer.
You too. Thanks again.
Kind of just like a quick look into like how I'm answering the questions and everything. I'm kind of going for a more, kind of like how I would respond to most situations, but for the most part, I can go with more the casual approach and the logical approach. I mean, every so often you'll see me pick an emotional answer, but for the most part, I pick you know, the casual, just because if you know me, I'm pretty damn sarcastic. And then there's the, I'm losing my train of thought. Yeah, whatever. It's all gone.
Damn shame about your dad, though. I'm sorry we couldn't save him.
I haven't heard how he died.
Like a hero. That's how. That's the only part that matters. I've met one Pathfinder. Well, two with you. But I figure that's the way to go. Taking your last breath on an uncharted world.
Yeah. Sounds about right.
Now I just need to make sure your sister here pulls through.
Are you staying here on the Hyperion?
You know that moment when you realize you're just getting too old? Ha, right, look who I'm talking to. Trust me, it happens. For me, it was Habitat 7. Watching you guys running around, dodging lightning and the cat, it's a young man's game. Pains me to admit it, but it's passed me by.
What will you do on the Hyperion?
We still have thousands of people taking a nap here, and they need tending to. And this way I can look out for Sarah.
Does anyone else catch the fact that our main character sounds like Nathan Drake? Sounds like Nolan North.
How did you end up with the initiative?
Well, you reach a point...
I think it's in his inflection. I think it's very similar.
I'd accomplished everything in the Milky Way I could. I was locked into a future of diminishing returns. So coming here was the world's biggest midlife crisis. Chance to wake up in the morning and feel hope instead of arthritis.
How's Sarah doing?
Her condition's stable, I see signs of REM activity in the brain, so she's dreaming. Means all the wiring still works.
How'd this happen?
It was dumb luck, really. We hit the scourge at the worst possible moment, just as the stasis revival was kicking in. It's a vulnerable moment, coming out of a 600-year nap, then wham! Circuits fried and overloaded the neural pathways. Don't worry, I'm on it. We're not losing another writer.
That's all, Harry. Thanks.
Don't be a stranger. If anything changes with Sarah, I'll let you know.
Pathfinder, I'm Nigel McCoy. Just got out of cryo.
Welcome to Andromeda, Nigel.
Thank you. It's bittersweet, though. My little brother Dash was stationed on the Nexus. I just learned he died on Eos, trying to start a settlement.
That's awful. I'm sorry, Nigel.
Yeah. We were going to start families out here together. I have a pendant our father wore. Dash had its match. Will you reunite them?
Of course.
In his digital journal, he mentioned a spot on Eos where he'd go to think. If you could leave the pendant there.
All right, then. Somebody's got to explain to me, what exactly is the Pathfinder? I mean, like, I understand, like, he's the leader of the kind of, like, the expedition crew, you know, we're going out and looking and finding planets and whatnot, but, like, they treat him like he's a god or something. It's kind of spooky, if you ask me.
Ready to see what Tan gave us?
I hear it's something special. Pathfinder en route. How's the ship?
In final checks, looking great.
We won't be long. The way things are going, we'll be on our own out there.
In other words, we're making this up as we go.
We used to call that tactical improvisation. But at least we'll be doing it in style. They call her the Tempest.
Nothing against the Normandy, but I think this thing looks damn cool.
Let's go take a closer look.
Let's pick it up a bit, people. We're 14 months late.
So you're the one who's making everything happen. Vetra Nix. Initiative Wrangler, Provisioner, Gunner, and everything in between. Are we ready? The sooner we get out of here, the better.
You're coming with us?
Yes. Otherwise, there's no way they're letting this ship off the station.
What's the rush?
Just don't want to waste any more time.
Hold it! You're not going anywhere.
Damn it.
Whatever happened, it wasn't me. I just got here.
Director Addison wants to see a complete report of the Tempest's supplies, munitions, and crew.
Director Tan overruled Addison.
The ship's loaded out with equipment for outpost discovery, squarely under Director Addison's purview.
Seen you around. Ben, right? Came here with a family, didn't you? Son still in cryo? I could pull some strings, get him to the front of the line.
Really?
Yeah, really.
They told me he wasn't essential, but I miss him.
I know. I got family too, Ben.
It's done. Addison's gonna kill me.
Thank goodness. For a sec, I thought I was gonna have to deal with Addison again.
And no one wants that. All things considered, it was an easy ask. And right now, you need people tearing down obstacles, not putting up more.
It's kind of new. I don't.
Someone who cares about doing stuff and not just talking about it.
This is kind of interesting. I don't really remember meeting a female Turian in the original trilogy. I mean, I bet there was one. I just don't remember it. Because most of the Turians were male that we met. And it's just like that female Krogan that we met, I think, in the last video was kind of strange. Because I don't think, until the third game, I don't think we actually ever met a female Krogan.
Everything's state-of-the-art. Labs, sensors, exploration gear. Plus her crew, of course. The best in their field.
Ah, glad to see you looking well.
The engine core is based on the Ark's Odyssey drive.
It runs a hell of a lot quieter.
That's Gil Brody. Engineer, mechanic, all-around wrench jockey. We call this the research room. There's space for upgrading equipment, gathering intel.
Router engaged. Securing connection to Tempest.
Welcome aboard, Sam. And Ryder, of course.
All run by Suvi Anwar, our science officer. Your quarters are below. Plenty of space up here to get everyone together. It's all yours. She's light, stealthy, and the fastest ship in her class.
It's really gonna be something, isn't it?
I haven't even shown you the best part. When you're ready to fly, head over to the bridge. Our pilot should have everything good to go.
I mean, that's cool and all, but I'm going to explore the ship a little bit. Ooh, level 3. Let's see here. I'll go into tech. Incinerate. Definitely gonna pick up flamethrower. There we go. Oh wow, I still have 2 more points. Confirm that. Go here. We'll go into combat fitness. Just kind of want to, like I said, I want to get that extra holster. Let's go to, over to Cora. Charge Nova. Let's give her a point in the Sorry Commando. And with 1 point left, can't really do anything. Vetra, she's obviously, I get one of our one of our squad mates. Let's see, concussive shot, Turian smuggler. I kind of go more into their, I don't want to say ancillary skills, but you know, their, whatever you want to call these skills, just because it gives us a, actually, we'll also give her power armor. Just because I think those support skills will really help me out once, crap hits the fan. A little bit more than that, and point in defense. Oh, he only has 2 points. Then give him a point in defense and call it. Can you change their... Oh, cool, you get a little backstory on them. Oh, that's interesting. I'm just kind of making this up as I go, just so you know. I'm
better head to the bridge when we're ready to go. Oh.
The meeting room. You can make vid calls from the central table or just get the crew together. We call this the research room. You can run research projects and coordinate with the Nexus from here.
Some serious kit over here. Seems like we're forever racing, but there's always time to check out new toys.
Useful ones.
Always game for new toys.
This makes use of old ones. Like anything you grabbed on Habitat 7. Raw minerals, tech, doesn't matter. The research station will strip that stuff down, give you options.
I'll take any advantage I can get, even if it's exploring junk.
Hey, with tech like this, it won't be junk for long. Not after we're through. If the best we get is what we make, still the best. Check it out.
Alright, R&D terminal. Starting, take a look at research, development, craft. Alright. Let's research. Milky Way, Helios, and unknown. Remnant. Alright. These things are cool. I have no points, I guess, in Milky Way, so I guess I can't make these weapons. I do have points in this one, so... I only have 110. I don't have enough to make that pistol, to make that... Oh, that's a cool, it's a sword. Do I have something for a pistol? Nah, I don't have enough points or whatever. That's development. That's okay. So it's all right. So I'm assuming it's kind of like at the very bottom you see the required materials. Okay. Through Predator. Let's compare this to the Viper. That's the current rifle I'm using. It's got a better rate of fire, but it drops out and damage. And I'm not a big fan of losing damage. Alright, we'll dive more into that later. They can see they could probably get really deep.
Our tech lab is an engineer's dream. It's perfect for any delicate technical work.
Wonder how fast that engine core clocks in.
That's the bio lab. We can grow plants for food and oxygen, keep any specimen safe.
Like I said, this video is probably going to be a lot of me just kind of exploring the ship.
Excuse me. I need to make sure we have everyone's medical files from the Nexus. Come by after launch. and we can catch up properly.
Hello, what are you? Oh, okay. Okay, never mind. I was thinking that this might be like a combat testing area, but no. No, it's not. I was incorrect.
Right. Finalizing orders, flight plan, command access. Ready when you are. Ready when you are.
Alright, so no conversation with her like there was with Liam. Like a little back room kind of dude.
Hi there. Can we talk and stuff later? I've got some last minute adjustments.
Alright.
She'll be ready to go when you are.
We're almost out there. Finally.
Yeah, okay. So, I guess I really don't have options to just kind of hang out and talk to people.
Hey.
Okay. I have no idea what that's about. I think that's multiplayer stuff, now that I think about it.
Hey.
This console reports on the militia's current strike team missions, Pathfinder. Please speak with Tyrion Candrus for authorization to participate.
Departure trajectory locked, Nexus Control. Ah, time for introductions. You must be Ryder, Kalojath. A pleasure to be here, and to meet you, of course. I'll be piloting the Tempest at your word. Quite the ship, but it'll take a Pathfinder's guidance to see us through Helios.
I'm new to this. Being a Pathfinder running a ship?
You'll be fine. As for the ship, I can help. I knew the Tempest when she was a blueprint. I was test pilot for the Tempest's early prototypes. I admit, I'm itching to see how she performs out here.
So how do I...
The console syncs with your implant. Just swipe, touch a destination here, and the nav system calculates everything. Very efficient.
It was optimized for a Pathfinder.
Everything's secure, if you're ready.
Is anyone ready for something this big? I guess we have to be.
All right. Excuse me. Excuse me.
Command access is transferring successfully.
Science and monitoring stations look fine. Lexi's reporting in.
Helm is green. Gil reports the drive core is online.
This is it, Ryder. The Tempest is yours. Unless you've got something to say for the log.
Things seem bad, but we've already beaten the odds, and we'll beat them again. You know it, I know it. So let's show them what we got.
Nexus Control, this is the Tempest, ident 2527, prepping to depart.
Departure vector verified, Tempest. Godspeed, Pathfinder.
To Eos, then. What would have been our Habitat 1?
Two failed outposts put an end to that idea.
Maybe we can turn things around. Kalo, take us in.
All right. Well, Let's get things going. Sorry if it was kind of weird that I went through that door. There was probably a cut back to... it was like in the door, to go to the bridge. Then it kind of cut back to me picking up that quest. I don't know, something bugged. And it froze right as I was...
Andromeda Initiative Habitat 1. Designated EOS.
As I was going through the door, so...
Until no one else showed, and we got clobbered. Twice.
Why has Sam altered frequency detection?
What are we hearing, Sam?
There is a signal pathfinder. I recommend an immediate examination of EOS.
Alright, game on. Oh god, not this again.
A mirror of the signal on Habitat 7. Possible atmospheric manipulation.
Is that possible?
We'll find out. If it is like Habitat 7, no doubt we'll run into the cat.
Oh, oops, I'm oops, oops. So now we get to... Alright, so it's kind of doing what 3 did with the whole weight of your items kind of thing. Okay, well, I'll go with my Omni Blade. I'll keep the M3 Predator. And keep the Viper. Let's see if we can mod these things. I'll take a pistol scope. No mods available. Alright. As far as armor goes, I really can't switch it up. Consumables. I keep what I have. I probably won't use the consumables that much. I'll bring Cora and... Bring the unknown... We'll bring Vetra along with us. I thought your twin was also supposed to be a squad mate in the game. Apparently not. That's an unknown, so I guess we'll figure out what that is eventually. Okay.
Suiting up. See you on the ramp.
Hope we're all that ready.
It seems like we only have six squad mates.
Integrating search area from Sam. How he pulled that mystery signal through the storms, I have no idea.
Multisensory neural collation. Amazing.
Factory fresh across the board. Spinning up the compensators.
You're already tuning the displays.
We'll get a better read on this pass than the Nexus has had in months.
What? I said a lot of people have their hopes pinned on us. They gave up on EOS. I can't blame them. Expected a golden world, instead they saw their friends die. Never know how that'll affect.
Sorry. You okay?
This is exactly why we came. A new galaxy? A new ship? I can't wait to get both a little dirty.
Pathfinder, the Tempest checks out. We're good.
I mean, you look like you went cross-eyed there for a second.
Take us down.
You have no idea how long I've wanted a Pathfinder to say that.
Core is hot.
Shields holding, adjusting entry.
We got this. Right?
Hell.
I
There. Set us down at this nav point.
Even supposed to do here?
Reports state this planet suffers deadly storms that are contaminated by radiation from the Scourge. EO's deployment was incomplete due to environmental hazards and ultimately hostile encounters.
Plus, no Pathfinder. If EOS is like Habitat 7, that signal we scanned must be connected with the atmosphere. We could use the outpost's antenna to track it down. Door's getting emergency power, but it's code locked.
Site 1 issued individual security codes. Each outpost self-organizes and sets its own protocol.
Just say we can't open it without codes.
We can't open it without codes.
They must have known these wouldn't last in these conditions.
How would they know? They didn't have a Pathfinder.
They do now. We'll make EO's home.
My controller vibrated. Ah, did it again. The hell is it? I don't see anything to scan, so...
suffered our first death today. Storm came out of nowhere. Lockley tried to cover our crops. Lost his footing. Got swept away. His wife is still in cryo. Maybe by the time they wake her up, I'll know what to say.
Got a code lock key.
Handy. It'll get us in.
I'm guessing that point up there is where we're supposed to take that medallion or pendant or whatever that guy gave us on, back on Helios. Is Helios right? Is that what it is? The Nexus? Whatever it was called.
Main door had power, but not the interior doors?
Full functionality would require an active power relay station.
That means the... Tenant. The logs might tell us what's up with the power relay.
Boop, boop, boop.
I got a partial log, but I can't turn on the antenna. Something's blocking the power.
A remote lock is active. The interference originates from a nearby power relay tower.
So we're not the only ones interested in what happened.
Sandstorms, radiation.
Let's check out this relay tower.
What the hell was Addison thinking, sending us here? EOS might have looked great back in the Milky Way, but up close, it's a hellscape. Farmingale's on my case to stay positive. Put on a brave face for the rest of the team, but I can't shake the feeling that I'm gonna die out here.
Look at this place. It's a wasteland.
The radiation in Eos's atmosphere makes it difficult to cultivate life.
Radiation?
Whoa, what the?
Our suits protect against that, right?
Site 1 contains shield masts to dampen the brunt of contamination.
But if we go outside Site 1's perimeter?
That would not be advised.
That's neat. That, shoulder charge thing is a... I cloak. Alrighty then.
Structure up ahead. Sam?
It fits the profile of a power relay station, Pathfinder.
Right. We get it running, maybe buildings get power.
And we can hunt that signal down.
It's inoperable, Pathfinder.
Too long in this environment without power.
We didn't expect this kind of environment. Who could?
Pathfinder, that door is locked. Until power is restored, there is no way to unlock it or gain entry to these buildings.
Huh. Guess that ship wasn't Ket then. They don't knock.
There are people here? We thought everyone left was gone.
Of course you did. Now shove off. Find your own salvage. This spot's taken.
So you're a salvager. Got a name? I'm Ryder.
Clancy. Making an honest living by... Wait, Ryder? As in Pathfinder? The Nexus just can't let Eos go, can it? However much it fails down here.
I'm tracking a signal that will help Eos. I only need power for the antenna.
Look, I cut the power for a reason. The Ket are patrolling today. You turn the power relay back on, they'll know there's a juicy target alive down here.
Is it smarter to hide and hope, or take a chance that might save this whole planet?
I remember when people used to talk like that. Okay, I'll enable the generators out there. You want to poke the tiger, it's on you.
Expect trouble when we start the generators.
I really like this jump pack.
There's an error in the startup sequence. Manual input required.
Damn it.
Please scan one of the pylons to determine a hackable input location. Generator interface possible. Location marked.
Generator is active. Sam, our friend Clancy, was he part of the outpost team here?
No, Pathfinder. According to Nexus records, he's stationed in the hangar bay.
So he used his clearance to sneak off the station, make some credits on the side. Don't sound so impressed.
We've got company.
I'm liking this jetpack thing more and more. Okay, maybe now that I know that I can't swap between Oh cool, it outlines them. When I can, I think I'm gonna get rid of that,
They weren't kidding about the cat.
Pistol scope.
Power relay station is ready for activation, Pathfinder.
Cause I can't, like, not use it.
Took down all those Ket? Sure, use the power relay.
Hell, take whatever you like. Word of advice, though. If that signal of yours is out past the perimeter, you'll need a ride.
A ride?
Shuttles aren't fun in these winds. You need wheels. I think they kept a little something in storage.
Didn't get around to salvaging it yet?
I tried. It ain't that simple. Might be easier for a Pathfinder, though. We're heading to our shuttle. Keep this up. Maybe next time we'll find more than just salvage around here.
Don't suppose you've got anything we can use?
What, RPG? Ooh. As far as I can tell, he doesn't have, like, a total amount that... So we can just, I'm guessing that we can just kind of get rid of all the crap that we don't need. Because it doesn't look like he has, like, an amount that, you know, it's not like Fallout where he has a limited amount of cash. M96 Madoc. Isn't that what I'm using? It's better than a lot, but I don't like the drop in damage.
Power restored. We should have access to everything in Site 1 now, right, Sam?
Correct. Plus, I've located the source of the signal we detected in orbit. It's coming from the large alien structure just beyond Site 1. The structure appears almost identical to the one your father used to adjust the atmosphere on the previous planet. It's worth investigation.
That almost feels like a lead. Damn right it's worth investigating.
A warning. Radiation levels beyond the perimeter of Site 1 are well above acceptable limits. You cannot proceed without additional protection.
All the more reason to see if that alien structure can make a difference to this planet. Come on, we better find that vehicle Clancy mentioned.
Now that power is restored, we can investigate the nearby buildings.
I gotta, I'm debating if I want to turn off helmets. Tell me in the comments, would you prefer I turn them off, or keep them on? Or would you just like them off in conversation, you know, that kind of... It's so weird to watch. Like, I can't think of, like, what that's used for. Because it seems like, at least what I'm doing, it doesn't do any damage.
Well, what do you know? The outpost research center is still intact.
Updating the Tempest on this critical recovery.
Research was always key to the initiative. We'll need it here, too.
This tech is how we survive in Andromeda. Ingenuity on the ground.
Someone else agrees. This research center was used recently to monitor the alien signal.
This gives us the tools to find the source, and maybe whoever else is looking.
The research station is back online. I've provided a list of weapons we can build by gathering the required components.
Okay, so we can create a weapon. Pistols. Compare it to the current one I'm using. Phalanx. Oh, I know what this thing is. It's like that. It's a revolver-esque. Actually, yes, I like this pistol. So, it's in my inventory. So, can I switch weapons on the fly? It does not look like I can switch weapons on the fly. No matter how much I wish I could, I cannot. How am I looking for? Thing.
Special requisition all-terrain scout rover.
A Nomad. Six-wheel drive, jump jets, just what you need.
So shiny.
This must be what Clancy meant.
The crate requires an access code from a forward station. Forward stations act as emergency resupply checkpoints. Several are currently in orbit.
I can call one down. Let's find a good spot.
Automated protocols activated. Deploying forward station.
Oh, okay. If I remember correctly from preview, you call this down. This lets you switch up your loadout, supply. Okay. So you can't necessarily switch weapons on the fly, but you can change it up. All right. Switch out the M3 Predator for the Carnifex. Or mods. Yep, mod. I think mods are... That's what I thought. Mods are kind of, that takes extra spare ammo. That scope.
Looks like the forward station supplies are intact.
Downloading Nomad Crate access code.
I dig that that pistol too. I mean, it's almost like having a Magnum. Which, if you know me, I love revolvers and cowboys and all that good stuff. All right, this thing already looks cooler than the Mako. And if you're sitting in there saying, oh, but the Mako was awesome, you're wrong. The Mako sucked. I am hated constantly for my views on that.
The Nomad should handle pretty smooth. Check both forward and reverse, would you?
Alright, handles a lot like a normal vehicle. It's nice that they got rid of the... how it controls kind of like a warthog from, controls like, I'm trying to think here. They used to control like warthogs from,
Can't get traction. It's too steep. Switch to six-wheel drive. It'll get you up there in a snap.
Oh, that's neat that you mine while on the planet. What was I saying? I like how the... Jesus! Oh, there we go. Okay. So that's what L1 does. It switches to... So it's more speed versus interesting.
They'll get you over most obstacles. If you need more juice, the boost...
Got it. Signal's coming from that structure up ahead.
I was saying, like, so many people love the, the Mako from the original Mass Effect. Personally, hated it. Combat in it wasn't fun. It controlled, like, warthogs from Halo. Never a big fan of those. I like this better.
From above us.
There, look, up near that scaffolding.
It's working, but I'm just getting random symbols. Glyphs.
With more glyphs to expand my database from Habitat 7, I could interface fully with the console.
And hopefully start up whatever helps the atmosphere.
I could provide analysis via the scanner, Pathfinder.
Okay, so I think I have to climb using my weird jump pack thing.
It's slippery, but there's a great view!
Who'd be crazy?
I think that's enough.
Building connection. I apologize for any discomfort. The system seems unstable.
This would happen when my dad tried doing this?
Your father interfaced directly with the atmosphere processor. That proved extremely hazardous. These structures could reveal its control center. System remains unstable. Doubling our power input might accelerate the process.
I'll give it a shot.
Wait! Back up. Literally.
Whoa! Easy. You've come this far. Just let it ride. I've been studying this keck for months. I don't know how you activated those glyphs, but you have to let them cycle through their channels. It's going to be all right. Trust me, okay? I know. Who am I? I mean, it's obvious who you are. I saw the ship swoop in. You're a Pathfinder. Was beginning to think the initiative just made you guys up so the rest of us wouldn't lose hope, but you're for real, huh?
Maybe you want to knock me down a couple more times to make sure.
No, that's okay. You're obviously corporeal. Pretty solidly built, actually.
I felt like a compliment.
Well, look at that.
System has stabilized. I'm establishing a connection.
Oh, crap.
These things from Habitat 7.
Later, just take them out. Keep targeting that one. They make a little bot.
Not bad. My first tangle with the Remnant was a lot messier.
The Remnant?
These monoliths, the Observer and Assembler bots, they're all the remnants of something much bigger. But that's too long. Ugh, I hate long. So, the Remnant. Like, my name's better as Petey.
Thanks for helping with those things. I'm Ryder.
You're a mystery. I've been studying those glyphs for months, and then you arrive and... Poof, solved.
I saw this tech clear the skies on Habitat 7. We're hoping it could do the same for Eos.
Huh. Atmosphere manipulation? Maybe. Fits the model. All remnant tech is connected. You interfaced with this monolith somehow, and now it's pinging the others. If you wake them up too, they must lead to whatever master switch might fix the radiation.
You're sure it'll help Eos? Or am I just a handy way to get those monoliths online?
I'm a little offended by that, Ryder.
Uh-huh.
Okay, maybe. But we both get what we want. Just try. It's not like we can make this planet worse. Here, take my nav points. I've got to figure this interfacing out. Just be careful. This planet's all kinds of strange.
Shields are up!
All right, guys. I gotta go do some stuff. I just want to try and grab a nap before I have to go have to my first class today. Thank you for watching. You can find me on Facebook, Twitter, the website. It's all down in the description below. Please remember to like, comment. If you're not already, please subscribe to the channel. Stay tuned for more next time. And until then, guys, I'm AJ Gels. See you on the Third Game Channel. Thanks for watching. I'm out.